he's an example for sport people, but I don't think
he is.
When you talk to him, he doesn't look like he has the balls of the, you know,
he does
fucking kill people.
He does have that.
He's against violence against women, domestic violence. He helps kids with cancer.
People underestimate Sergio because of his look. He has that look like, oh, this guy's a pushover, he's a pretty boy. You know, he ain't nothing. But, you know, the matter of fact, the guy fights.
Zoolander, that's what I've heard. But I've been with him when we go to visit kids that have one day to live. And he takes the time and he does a lot of stuff like that without people knowing. The day of his last fight, there was a kid in a wheelchair. Uh-huh. And Sergio has a million things to do. He takes the time to hang out with the kid for 45 minutes.
Like I said, I mean, as a person, you asked me before if the guy is a really, and I think he's going to be like De La Hoya, and I thought that De La Hoya was an excellent. They said like two or three guys from Argentina that they really help crap out of people. The other one is the basketball player.
Ginobili?
Ginobili.
Oh, he's a nice guy.
He's a southpaw guy. Yeah, but they said that the guy opened schools, opened gyms.
He makes NBA like, kind of money.
He established money that, you know, he has a long-time contract, while fighters don't make those long-time contracts.
Tell us the story about Sergio buying you the whole role.
He bought one of the fighters, one of my fighters, the amateur fighters, and a whole set of friends that went to go see Areola.
You were in a fight.
Yeah,
Martinez happened to sit with you guys in the same row.
Yeah, he was.
And he said, okay, drinks on me for everybody, the whole row.
The whole row.
And everybody bought something?
Yeah, of course. You know, everybody got a drink. You know, I was there when the guys were drinking, having their drinks, and a couple of the guys told me, yeah, Sergio Martinez bought us a drink.
That was really nice of him.
You know, like, who does that? Like I always thought about Israel Vasquez. I remember I was working on the heavy bag. Come on, Israel Vasquez was world champion. He went and my shoe was untied. He went up and tied my shoe. You know, not
your shoe's
these.
Still untied.
These are. But I'm talking about my boxing shoes.
That was nice of him.
You know, nobody like. It's rare that you find humble people like that. And Sergio Martinez, even though, like when we went to pick him up at the airport, he was a gentleman straight out. Like he didn't act like he was a big shot. He was just humble like everybody. And that's when you give fighters respect, like Margarito. Margarito, even I was never a big fan of Margarito as a fighter because I don't like guys that get hit. You know, but as a person, great guy, a gentleman, always took pictures with everybody. Same way with Soto Carras. Stop. I remember when Soto Carras fought Mike Jones the second time. It took us half an hour to get from the weigh-in to the restaurant, and it was maybe like, like 20 yards away. You know, that's saying a lot. That's really guys like them, I take my hat off to them.
So what happens when you see a fighter that refuses to take pictures or sign autographs?
I lose respect. I can't really say much. I lose respect.
Cotto doesn't like to take pictures,
you know, if that's
or sign autographs.
If that's the case with Cotto, you know, the thing is...
I'm just being honest, that's fans, not
me. If you're a young guy, you're a kid that, you know, I have a kid right here, he's a big Cotto fan. And he wants to meet
Cotto. I know, he's Puerto Rican.
He's half Puerto Rican, but okay. You know, he's Puerto Rican, oh well. But he wants to meet Cotto, but... When you have a kid like him, like his eyes just glitter. They want to meet somebody like a fighter like Cotto. You know, of course they want it. Is it an admiration that a fighter like Cotto will sign him the glove, take some pictures? That's all. Maybe 5-10 minutes of
talented like Danny Garcia. He's Puerto Rican too, and he's much nicer. Find a new idol. There you have it, George Diaz. Stay tuned for the Flash Boxing Gym right here in Van Nuys. I'm Eli Sekback reporting.